you know that Sidney Crosby has 8 points in his last two games. You got to figure this guy, Evgeny Malkin's, going to have one of his explosions pretty soon. Maybe tonight, as the Stanley Cup champion Pittsburgh Penguins meet the Colorado Avalanche.
We'll not forget anytime soon. That's because Mason's father, Mike, promised him a goal on his birthday on Monday, and it said you cranked out three. Well, it's not his birthday anymore, but how do you continue to give yourself the gift of giving?
It was pretty cool doing that for him. Obviously, I was going to try for a goal, but it worked out, so I'm happy for the little guy.
How do you continue to keep the goals coming tonight against a Colorado team?
I think if we play the way we've been playing the last few games, we're doing the simple things. We're spending a lot of time in the offensive zone. It'll come for us, and that's our plan tonight.
All right, Mike, thanks for the time.
Yep.
Now it comes to the point, and Brett Clark, they set it up from the half wall. John Michael Lyle sneaking in the back door, right to the front of the net. They score. I don't know if they banked that one in or not. Gagliardi was
certainly did, and you're looking right now at that offside. No, keep playing here.
Here we go. Penguins have a chance here with 10 seconds to go in the period. Down the right wing is Crosby. Over to Ruff. He's there for Crosby. He scores! What a give and go! And the Penguins have tied the game at one. With 6.1 seconds to go in the period, the Penguins always play to the horn.
You got Crosby, you got Malkin, and you got Rupp. And you know Rupp, we already know that Rupp can play on a top line. He's already shown he's got the hands. There's a play by Malkin. Rupp to Crosby, Crosby to Rupp and back. I mean, that's picture perfect give and goes there after the Penguins take advantage of the Avs trying to pinch on a faceoff deep inside the Penguins' zone. I mean, it's just
at one goal apiece, and we've seen a lot of last-second goals. Of course, Billy Guerin's against Boston a couple weeks ago. Mark Eaton had a late one towards the end of the period, and you guys also worked one out there in the end of the first period.
Yeah, we got a good opportunity with a two-on-one late in the period, and Rupper made a great play. He set me up there for an open net.
You guys have 14 shots on goal, but it seems like the Avalanche are sending two men in on the forecheck. We know that they block a lot of shots. Have they been able to frustrate what you guys are trying to do at all offensively in the first 19 and a half minutes of that first period?
Yeah, I think they've done what we've expected. You know, they've worked really hard, and they create a lot of turnovers. So for us, our work ethic has to be a little bit better. We have to make sure that we're spending more time in their end and not give them a chance to create those turnovers.
Sydney, as always, thanks for the time.
Okay, thank you.
Riley was taking third overall.
Adams.
It's Adams going against Hendricks.
Good thing he didn't pull that trick in my faceoff.
Adams fires a right at Hendricks, holds him off now with the left. Hendricks throws a couple of rights and misses. Adams comes back with a right, and now Adams goes down as Hendricks got the leverage on him, was able to dump him to the ice. A good battle between a couple of middleweights there. Wiles. Kowalski, Clark moving into the back door, from the back door, right to the front of the net. The defenseman, number five, as Lyles holds it to the corner now for Clark. And they move bodies around on their power play. Centering pass, right off the stick. Gagliardi, he scores again.
No,
now I think they blew the whistle.
Yes.
The puck was actually not frozen, but the referee lost sight of it. Gagliardi got a stick in there, was able to poke it free. He saw the puck, the referee didn't, and the whistle blew before he had a chance to poke it into the net. It would have been a second goal for TJ Gagliardi.
Yeah.
Sacco can't believe it, but hey, the whistle blew. There's nothing you can do about it.
It's not when the whistle blows, it's when you lose sight of it. So the puck is over the line when you hear the whistle, but it's when the referee loses sight of it and he's in the act of blowing the whistle.
The whistle was blown before the puck crossed the line.
So, you know, when they say that the whistle was blown before the puck crossed the line, the referee lost sight of it. The puck wasn't over the line. So he blew the whistle.
Mustafa Tedesco is our Chevy player interview, and I know that you continue to come oh so close when it comes to scoring a goal, but that post got in the way of that goal there in the second period. You don't change a thing. You just keep driving the net, I would think.
Yeah, Gino was making a great play there. I was going to the net hard, and, I have an open corner there, and they shot it, and I just hit the post there. It's unfortunate, but we need to pick it up a little game. You know, they play back-to-back, and we need to take advantage of that. Felt like we need to skate more, a little harder, and just create more offense and cycle the puck, take advantage of the D.
You mentioned the back-to-back situation, but considering that they played last night, are you surprised that it's such a tight-checking, a close-checking game?
Yeah, I mean, they playing well, but I feel like we're not on the top of the game right now, and I feel like we just need to regroup and come out hard in the third period.
Ruslan, thanks so much.
Beforehand, he just got it over the outstretched glove of Malkin.
Gagliardi, Hannon, and Quincy out here for the Avs. Crosby, cross ice, Gagliardi, he scores! Billy minute, but the Penguins take the lead, a power play goal.
And the penalty had just expired to Adam Foote. Just expired, so the Penguins don't get the backside power play, but they do get the 5-on-3 goal. And Billy Guerin, who was robbed seconds before, you see Sidney Crosby sold the shot. He got the goaltender to free, look, freeze him up. Yep, just enough. You can see Budaj's legs get a little bit rubbery as he bit. He flinched, and the puck went tape to Guerin. Put it in the wide open cage. Budaj couldn't get across, and the Penguins.
They ended up scoring two goals in the final minute to tie the game. They were down 5-3. So there's going to be a steal here for Staal with an empty net. Here comes Jordan Staal. And you can say goodnight to the Avs because the Pittsburgh Penguins have made a 3-1 with 48.9 seconds to go.
Well, it didn't come without a little bit of trepidation for the Penguins. Hajduk coming down the slot, backhands it to the far post. It just went off the skate of Sergei Gonchar, just grazed his skate. Or no, maybe not. Wide open opportunity. Stastny misses it, and Staal goes the other way. You're not going to get a much better chance. Of course, if you had a right-handed shooter on that post, it might have been easier.
Stastny takes the faceoff, pulls it towards the wall. And the Penguins, Malkin got it free to Crosby, back to Malkin. Another empty net opportunity for Staal to Crosby, a shot, he scores. Sidney Crosby has another one. It's 4-1 Pittsburgh, and Crosby now has another point to get one more point closer to Joe Thornton. That's 11 points in three games for Sidney Crosby.
Yep, give him 19 goals. 19 goals for Sidney Crosby already. And everybody getting into the act, wanting to get a point on that goal. Take the defense out of the equation. So give assist to Staal and Malkin.
And Staal said, I'm not going to. But in the end, once again, the Penguins with a big number on the board, 33 shots to only 16 for the Avs. And the Pittsburgh Penguins have now won 6 of their last 7 games, 8 of their last 10. And they defeat the Avs here tonight 4-1.
Yeah, Sidney Crosby with the last goal. He didn't even start the shift with that stick that he scored with, Steg. He broke it right off the faceoff. So the Penguins training staff, Paul DeFazio, aware on the bench.